Good day all. I'd like to welcome all of you in this series of videos where we will discuss what is the tracheostomy, why they are insert it for the patients, how it will be inserted, what is our role as healthcare workers toward the tracheostomy, how we can take care of tracheostomy, doing the dressing, the cleaning, the suctioning, how to avoid the complications from tracheostomy, how we can take the sample, how we can do suction, and about the weaning and decannulation. To understand the tracheostomy, let's go back to the basics, how we are taking breath normally. Normally, we will take the breath by inhalation. The air will come from the environment, from the atmosphere, to through the nose, the mouth, it will go to the lung. Then there will be exhalation. The air will go out by exhalation. This is normally. Now, in certain cases, some people cannot take breath by their own. Due to different reasons, maybe like a tumor, maybe a losing of their consciousness, maybe during the surgery, maybe like neuromuscular diseases. As the result, that person cannot take breath by his own. Now, what they will do for this person, they will intubate. They will insert endotracheal tube. So he cannot take breath. Now they will insert the endotracheal tube. This intracheal tube is very beneficial for the people. They can take breath by the mechanical ventilator. They cannot do their own. They can take by the mechanical ventilator. Whenever they are inserting this endotracheal tube, yes, it is beneficial for the patient, but it associated with complications like infection and another difficulties. Now, if the patient needs this endotracheal tube for more than 2 weeks, the physician start to think about another alternative. It can do the same work with less complication. This alternative is tracheostomy. So this tracheostomy can stand for longer time with less complications. Later you will see the features for the tracheostomy. In most cases, you will find this is the scenario. The patient needs mechanical ventilator or airway. Now he cannot be extubated, so he needs prolonged intubation. They go to the tracheostomy. But this is not in the all scenarios. Maybe the patient has big surgery in the neck, like neck dissection, or he has tumor in the upper airway. Then they cannot put endotracheal tube for him. They will go to the tracheostomy immediately. Where they will insert a tracheostomy, it's in the second ring of the trachea. There are different types of tracheostomy. In this video, we will explain all of them, and I will make sure that it's easy for you to differentiate between these features or these types of tracheostomies. So we have sometimes fenestrated. I mean, like here, there is open. Okay, here there is no open. We call this one fenestrated. This is not fenestrated. You will see it in the video. Now, some tracheostomy are cuff and some of them not cuff. We mean by cuff is the balloon here. So some of them with balloon, some of them with no balloon. Some of them with inner cannula. This inner cannula, it will be immediately connected to the mechanical ventilator or ambu bag, okay? And we can take it out, clean it, then return it back. Okay, this one, they call it inner cannula. Some tracheostomy has no inner cannula. Immediately, this will go to the patient and there is nothing inside. It's immediately connected to the mechanical ventilator. So this is what they call it, inner cannula and no inner cannula. There are certain parts. It's in every tracheostomy. We will explain all of them. Look at this picture. Let's take it one by one. Here is the flange. Flange where you will see it outside the patient neck, and you can secure the tracheostomy by the tracheostomy tie by this flange. Okay, this one is movable. It will enable the patient to move right and left. Okay, at the same time, this one is secured. Now, if you look at the outer cannula where it will go to the patient himself, on the outer cannula, there is balloon, there is cuff. Here, you can inflate it by air using the inflation tube by this valve. Whenever you push with syringe, the air will go here and it will be inflated. Okay, here they call it pilot balloon because it can tell you how much this balloon is inflated. If this one too much inflated, here it will be inflated also stiffly. Now, usually we are not depending on the how much it's we can feel it. We are depending in manometer by numbers. And the cuff has to be 25 millimeter mercury because more cuff pressure, it can cause issues, and less also at the same time, it can cause leak and the secretions will go to the trachea. So this cuff need to be maintained within certain range of pressure. Now, if we look here, this is the inner cannula where it will be inserted here. Obturator, it's used when they are inserting the tracheostomy. Now it's the time to go and see the video to learn more, and it will be more clear for you.
What are the advantages or the benefit of tracheostomy? Tracheostomy is better than the endotracheal tube for the weaning from the mechanical ventilator. It will decrease the work of breathing because it's shorter, and it will decrease the laryngeal injury. The vented patients require less sedation. It's easier for oral care and secretion removal. It will improve patient comfort and acceptance and the tolerance. Patient can speak, can communicate, can eat, can even ambulate. So tracheostomy also can decrease the possibility of self-extubation or accidental extubation. Let's now speak about the parts of the tracheostomy, and we will start by the hub. The hub is the protruded part that you can see outside the tracheostomy. It has diameter of 15 millimeter. That one is universal. You can connect it to the mechanical ventilator, the ambu bag, the speaking valve, and the caps. The second part we will speak is the inner cannula, where it directly connected to the hub. And this will prevent the mucus, the secretions, to block the airway or block the tracheostomy. If you need to take it out, just turn it counterclockwise to release it to the left. And if you need to fix it, make it clockwise to the right. So you can remember, like, right is tight. Left is loose from the first letter. The outer cannula, which is also called shaft, this one make the main part, the main component of tracheostomy. That one will be inserted in the trachea. The outer cannula can be either fenestrated. We mean by fenestrated that it has opens or windows inside, or non-fenestrated. There is no window. Definitely, if the outer cannula fenestrated, the inner cannula should be fenestrated. This fenestration will allow the air to leak, to go through the mouth, the nose. This will produce a voice. Also, it's used as alternative for patient in the weaning process or the people who need tracheostomy forever. The outer cannula can be cuffed or non-cuff or cuffless. We mean there is balloon or there is no balloon. This balloon will prevent the leak around the tracheostomy shaft, used to maintain the air delivered from the mechanical ventilator to the lung. It means if you give by the mechanical ventilator 500 milli of air, this will go to the lung and it will come back. It will not leak around the tracheostomy and will go to the nose and mouth. No, it will be the same amount because the balloon will prevent the air to leak around the tracheostomy. You can inflate the cuff by the syringe, and you will use the pilot line, which we call it also inflation line. The cuffless, which does not has a cuff, sure has no pilot line. And it will be indicated for patient who does not require mechanical ventilation and able to tolerate cuff deflation without respiratory distress. Flange or neck plate, it has holes to attach to the thigh to fix the tracheostomy. On the flange, there is important information about the tracheostomy, the size, the diameter, the brand, the length. It will make the tracheostomy fixed inside the trachea, even the patient move. Obturator or the pilot, if we compare it to the cannula, inside the cannula there is a stylet, right? So this to facilitate the insertion of the cannula. This is almost similar to the same idea. It's a stylet, okay, used during the insertion to assist the insertion of the tracheostomy. Now, after insertion, immediately they will remove it, but they will keep it around in case of the emergency and they need to recannulate, they can use it. Tracheostomy tube tie, this one will use to keep the tracheostomy inside in the place to prevent accidental decannulation or the removal of the tracheostomy. It is attached to the flange and wrap around the neck. Other type of tracheostomy is a single cannula. There is no inner cannula. This will consist only the outer cannula only. Since there is no inner cannula, resistance may be reduced. However, the tracheostomy required to be changed if there is obstruction like mucus plug. Just remember that most of the manufacturers are recommending the tracheostomy tube to be changed approximately 30 days after placement. Now, here, just like one point, if you need to connect like ambo bag or the mechanical ventilator and you need to disconnect it, please fix it by your hand so it will not affect the placement inside the trach. It will not move.
I hope this explaining is clear for you, and see you in the next video. Thank you.